claim that I lied.
Unbothered, no big deal. That's how presidential spokesperson Harry Roque described the president's reaction to the recent move of former International Criminal Court prosecutor Fatou Bensouda to seek a full probe on the deaths in the Philippine drug war.
He shrugged off the opinion after checking the sources, media sources, kasi all lawyers know that will not stand in court. So we're confident, even if magpatuloy pa yan sa investigasyon, ang sinasabi ko nga, eh kung puro galing naman sa media ang gagamiting sources at galing sa mga makaliwang grupo, hindi po yan tatayo.
But just before stepping down, Bensouda disclosed in a statement that she had to take steps to preserve evidence regarding the Philippines. She said the preliminary examination for the Philippines had been at an advanced stage for over a year, but there were some evidence preservation opportunities which her office had to pursue. That's why she decided to complete them first before seeking authorization to proceed with an investigation and making it public. Her announcement on the Philippines came a day before her term ended. For Human Rights Watch, now is not the time to evaluate whether the pieces of evidence are hearsay, because there's still an investigation and there's still no case on trial. But this early, the group believes the president's own statements urging the killing of drug pushers and users will help to show that there is such a policy at the state level.
These statements are highly relevant to show this policy that exists. Now, whether or not it's sufficient to show individual culpability, again, that's a question for the prosecutor to determine. And for, you know, the evidence has to tell the story.
The pretrial chamber is expected to take about 3 months to decide whether or not to authorize the investigation. Bensouda submitted her request on May 24th. For Singh, Bensouda had a perfect record in seeking probes. In 6 cases, the pretrial chamber had never turned down her request, and the threshold is very low. Still, she clarified that should the probe push through, it will take time. But the lack of cooperation from the Philippine government, as Roque declared, will not hinder it.
The ICC has conducted these kinds of investigations without the cooperation of the government whose policies may be at issue. It certainly makes it more challenging, but by no means does it make it impossible to move forward.
She warned that should the Philippine government not cooperate, this might force the pretrial chamber, upon application by the prosecutor, to issue a warrant of arrest.
Given the lack of support that the government has already expressed very clearly and very consistently, I would expect that the court would probably go down the route of seeking arrest warrants rather than seeking the cooperation that's needed for a summons.
Also under the ICC rules, the presence of the person charged during the trial is necessary, as there is no trial in absentia. The next challenge would then be how to enforce the arrest. For now, a new prosecutor takes Bensouda's place, and the Philippines is just one of the many cases Karim Khan will have to deal with.
And I undertake, in my new position as prosecutor, to respect the statute, to comply with complementarity, and insist on independence. And I will endeavor to foster cooperation and collaboration wherever possible. The priority for me, and I believe that's the principle of the Rome Statute, is not to focus so much on where trials take place, but to ensure that the quest for accountability and inroads on impunity are made.
Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.